So picture this. Your AWS bill has just doubled. Your Lambda functions are all timing out. And your data, well, it's all gone stale. What's the culprit then? It could be a single line of Python code that seemed harmless at very first. Hi, I'm Stuart. Today, I'm going to show you how default arguments in AWS Lambda can turn into an expensive nightmare. And more importantly, how to architect your functions the right way. Let's look at some examples together. And what we'll do is we'll see how we can improve all of our Lambda functions. So let's take a look at this code. What does this code do? Well, this code example demonstrates a common pattern which many developers, including me, have used when trying to optimize Lambda functions. The function here accepts an event parameter containing the user ID and a context object from AWS Lambda. What is interesting here is the part that lies in its default argument. As you can see, we've defined user cache as an empty dictionary, and we've also got our settings with the default TTL, or time to live, and the max items value. When this function runs, what it will do is it will first check if our user ID exists in the cache. If it's found, it will return the cache data. And what this will do is it'll avoid DynamoDB operations. If not, however, it will fetch and process the data and it will store it in the cache and return the result. So looking at this here, you might think, well, the intention here is actually really sound. Caching frequently accessed data to reduce database calls and processing time. That all sounds good to me. However, this implementation has a critical flaw due to Python's treatment of mutable default arguments. So what happens here is, in Python, default arguments are evaluated when this function is defined, not when it's called. So this means all invocations of the functions share the same dictionary objects for the user underscore cache and settings. This leads to an unexpected behavior in our Lambda environment. So let's now look at another example. This simulation demonstrates how memory usage grows over time in a Lambda container. During the first invocation, the function creates a cache entry for our user one. The key insight is that Lambda keeps the containers warm for subsequent invocations. So when we process 100 different users though, each invocation will add the same cache to the dictionary instead of creating a fresh one. The memory footprint here grows linearly with each new user. But this memory isn't released between invocations. The container thus maintains the bloated state until AWS decides to recycle it, which in some cases could be hours later. Okay, just finally now, let's just look at another example. And we will look some more at Lambda concurrency. This code reveals another subtle issue with Lambda concurrency. When your function receives multiple concurrency requests, AWS spins up separate containers to handle them. And each container gets its own Python interpreter. And consequently, its own version of the default arguments. This means user one might get a different result depending on which container processes their request. One container might have fresh data in its cache, while another one might have stale data, leading to inconsistent user experiences, which we don't really want. Okay, so we've seen how things can go wrong, but let's look how we can fix some of these examples that we looked at, and we'll jump into this in the next examples. Here, while looking at this implementation, it fixes the mutable default argument problem using a common Python idiom. So instead of using empty dictionaries as default values, we use none. And so when this function runs, we check if the arguments are none and initialize new dictionaries if needed. What this does is it ensures each function invocation gets its own fresh copies of the cache and setting dictionaries. The behavior is now predictable. So we have no shared state between invocations, no memory leaks, and no confusion with concurrent executions. And now finally, as a bonus, let's check out a monitoring example using AWS Lambda Power Tools, which is really useful. This monitoring implementation uses AWS Lambda Power Tools, which is a utility library which really simplifies the process of implementing AWS Lambda best practices. The code uses Python decorators to automatically log metrics and trace the execution. When we look at this decorator, we have the metrics.log_metrics decorator. And what this does is it ensures all of our custom metrics are sent to CloudWatch. Next, we have the trace.capture_lambda handler decorator. It adds a distributed tracing capability, helping us to understand the end-to-end execution flow of all of our Lambda function. So now that you understand the hidden dangers of default arguments in Lambda functions, it's really time to take action. First, review your existing Lambda functions for these patterns. They might be costing you some money right now. And second, implement proper monitoring using the AWS Lambda power tools I showed you. And finally, like and subscribe to the AWS YouTube channel. Thanks for watching and happy coding.